Have you ever wondered what happens when you pour too much water into a glass? It overflows, right? Now, imagine if that overflow could give you control over the entire kitchen. Sounds impossible? Well, in the digital world, a similar phenomenon called a buffer overflow attack can give hackers control over entire computer systems. Intrigued? Let's dive in. Welcome to our continuing series on ethical hacking concepts. Today, we're unraveling the mystery of buffer overflow attacks, a classic vulnerability that has been haunting the digital world for decades. Picture this: you're at a party, and someone asks you to remember a phone number. They start rattling off digits, and you dutifully memorize them. But they keep going, far beyond the usual 10 digits. What happens? At some point, your brain can't handle any more numbers, and you start forgetting or mixing up the earlier ones. This mental overflow is surprisingly similar to what happens in a buffer overflow attack. In the world of computer programming, a buffer is a temporary storage area for data. It's like a digital bucket designed to hold a specific amount of information. A buffer overflow occurs when more data is put into the buffer than it can handle. When this happens, the extra data can spill over into adjacent memory space, overwriting other data and potentially altering the program's behavior. Now you might be thinking, so what? The program crashes and that's it, right? If only it were that simple. In the hands of a skilled attacker, a buffer overflow can be exploited to execute arbitrary code, potentially giving them control over the entire system. Let's break down how this works with a simple analogy. Imagine you're filling out a paper form. The form has boxes for your name, address, and phone number. Each box is designed to hold a certain number of characters. Now, what if you had a really long name and kept writing beyond the box? You might end up writing over the address field, or even off the page entirely. In a computer, writing beyond the allocated space can overwrite critical data or even executable code. In a typical buffer overflow attack, the attacker finds a vulnerable program that doesn't properly check the length of user input. They then craft an input that's longer than the program expects. This input contains two key parts: a series of no operation instructions, which do nothing but slide the CPU's instruction pointer forward, and the attacker's malicious code. When the vulnerable program tries to process this oversized input, it overflows the buffer. The excess data, including the attacker's code, spills into adjacent memory. If done correctly, the program's execution flow is redirected to the attacker's code, which then runs with the same privileges as the vulnerable program. The consequences of a successful buffer overflow attack can be severe. An attacker might gain administrative access to the system, install malware, steal sensitive data, or use the compromised system as a launchpad for further attacks. One of the most famous examples of a buffer overflow attack was the Morris Worm in 1988. This worm exploited a buffer overflow vulnerability in the Unix Finger protocol, allowing it to spread rapidly across the internet. It affected thousands of computers and is often considered the first major internet security incident. More recently, the Heartbleed bug, discovered in 2014, was a buffer overread vulnerability in the OpenSSL cryptography library. While not a classic buffer overflow, it operated on similar principles, allowing attackers to read more data than they should have access to, potentially exposing sensitive information like passwords and encryption keys. Now, you might be wondering, why do these vulnerabilities exist? Can't programmers just be more careful? The truth is, buffer overflows often result from the tension between performance and security. Checking the length of every input can slow down a program, so some programmers might skip these checks in critical, high-performance areas. Additionally, many buffer overflow vulnerabilities exist in legacy systems written in languages like C, which don't have built-in protections against these types of attacks. So, how can we defend against buffer overflow attacks? First and foremost, secure coding practices are crucial. Programmers should always validate input lengths and use functions that automatically check buffer boundaries. Languages like Python, Java, and C# have built-in protections against buffer overflows, making them inherently safer for many applications. Next, there's a technique called address space layout randomization. This randomly arranges the address space positions of key data areas in a process, including the base of the executable and the positions of the stack, heap, and libraries. This makes it much harder for attackers to predict where their malicious code will end up in memory. Another defense is the use of non-executable memory. This technique marks certain areas of memory as non-executable, preventing code injected via a buffer overflow from running. Canaries, named after the birds once used to detect poison gas in coal mines, are another clever defense. A canary is a small random value placed between a buffer and control data. If a buffer overflow occurs, the canary is corrupted. The program checks the canary's value before continuing execution, and if it's changed, the program knows a buffer overflow has occurred and can terminate safely. For systems administrators and ethical hackers, regular security audits and penetration testing are crucial. These can help identify potential buffer overflow vulnerabilities before attackers exploit them. As users, one of the best things we can do is keep our systems and software up to date. Many buffer overflow vulnerabilities are discovered over time and patched in updates. As we wrap up, let's remember that while buffer overflow attacks might seem like a relic of the past, they continue to pose a significant threat. In 2020, a buffer overflow vulnerability was discovered in the SolarWinds Orion platform, potentially exposing thousands of organizations to attack. This serves as a stark reminder that even in our modern cloud-based world, the fundamentals of cybersecurity remain crucial. Understanding buffer overflows is not just about defending against a specific type of attack. It's about appreciating the delicate balance between data and code, between input and execution. It reminds us that in the digital world, boundaries matter, and exceeding them can have profound consequences. In our next video, we'll explore another fascinating concept in the world of ethical hacking. Until then, remember to validate your inputs, update your software, and never underestimate the power of a well-placed canary. Stay curious, stay secure, and keep pushing the boundaries of your knowledge, just not your buffers.